Hello and welcome. My name is Partho Majumdar. In the last video, we saw how we can do exponential regression using linear model using Excel. The model we discussed has one shortcoming. The shortcoming is that exponential regression using linear model does not try to minimize the errors. We can overcome this shortcoming by using non-linear model. To apply non-linear model, we can use solver in Excel. We'll go straight to Excel and see how this is done. So here we are in our Excel, which we just used for demonstrating exponential regression using linear model. Now I will add some columns here. The first column is for the predicted value of y. Next, we will compute the residual. And then we will compute the square of the residual. Now we computed our exponential regression model using linear model. So we got alpha is equal to 8.2062. And our beta was 0.0005. Alpha and beta, we can compute the predicted value of y. We say alpha into, we'll anchor it first. Into exponential of beta into x. We'll anchor beta also. So there we have computed the number of printers to be ordered according to this model. We have to compute the residual so that we can copy all the formulae together. And we compute the square of the residual. So there we have all our values. Now we'll compute the sum of squares of all the residuals. This is SSRESID. Now we invoke solver. In the solver, we will say that we want to minimize the sum of square of residuals. So we select the cell in which we have computed sum of squares of residuals and we will say we will minimize it. We will minimize it by changing the values of alpha and beta. So there we have set up our linear programming problem. And we said okay to solve, and we got the results. You see that the values of alpha and beta have changed. Also, the value of the sum of square of residuals has come down. So there you can see the new predicted values according to the new alpha and beta. Let's check whether this prediction is better after optimization. For that, we need to compute the R square. Now for computing R square, we require this value of sum of squares of total and sum of squares of regression. Now to compute the sum of squares of total, we have to find the average first. We find the mean of y. This can be found using average function. So we found the mean of y. Next, we compute y minus mean of y. We will anchor this. Next, we have to compute y minus mean of y whole squared. We compute this for all the observations. Now we will take the sum of all these values. This will give us the sum of squares of the total, SS total. Now we'll compute sum of squares of regression. This was SSRESID, sum of squares of residuals. This can be found by subtracting SSRESID from SS total. Now we can find R squared. This is SSREG divided by SS total. We find that R squared is 55%. So actually this has not yielded much benefit. In fact, it has become worse now.
That concludes our discussion. Thank you for listening.